Hello everyone. Today we are celebrating Draw a Bird Day all over the world. This day is meant for drawing a picture of a bird of your wish. Many of us see birds as a symbol of freedom because of their ability to fly. For many centuries, birds and their feathers have symbolized life, death, good and bad luck, the future, the past, and other signs. Birds not only add beauty to our planets, but play a crucial role in the ecosystem, pollination, and dispersal of seeds. Our mornings would not be that lively and cheerful had the birds not been there to make them sound so sweet. So, it is our duty to save the birds, ensure that they live together.
The bird I'm drawing is magpie, which is generally found in Europe, Asia, and North America. Magpie has a black head, chest, back, and a tail, and a white belly and shoulder patches. It has an extremely long green tail and a thick, slightly curved black bill. It has white patches on its wings. Magpies are known for their bold personality and intelligence. They mimic sounds around them, but they are scared of half-full plastic bottles and CDs.
Quetzals are strikingly colored birds in the trogon family. They are found in forests, especially in humid highlands. They are about 13 inches long. Quetzals have bluish green or golden green wings with a red belly. These birds feed on fruits, berries, insects, and small vertebrates such as frogs. Quetzal is a national bird of Guatemala because of its vibrant color.
The shoebill stork, also known as whale-headed stork, it derives its name from its enormous shoe-billed beak. The adult one will be in gray color, and the younger ones will be in brown color. They live in tropical East Africa near Zambia.
The Great Indian Bustard, or Indian Bustard, is found on the Indian subcontinent. In the world, there are totally 150 Great Indian Bustard. So on, the Great Indian Bustard is listed in the critically endangered species. At the Great Indian Bustard Sanctuary in Rajasthan, India, has totally 21 bustards according to the census 2009. It is a large bird with a horizontal body and long bare legs like an ostrich.
Here is a beautiful, intelligent and rarest bird I've drawn, Malabar hen. It has a shell-like structure which is the unique part of this bird. It has a colorful tail and a colorful neck which attracted me. The beaks are long like woodpecker, so I like this bird. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for giving this wonderful opportunity to me. Thanks all.
Wilson's bird of paradise is a species of passerine. They are rather small. They live in hill forest. They eat fruits, insects, and arthropods. Its unique feature is blue bonnet crown and the curly cute tail. Its length is 21 cm and it weighs 52 to 67 grams. Due to ongoing habitat loss, limited range, and exploitation, the Wilson's Bird of Paradise is evaluated as near threatened on the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. The male is red and black with a yellow mantle on its neck, light green mouth, rich blue feet, and two curved violet tail feathers. The female is a brownish bird with bare blue crown.
This bird is known as the hummingbird. Hummingbirds are native to the Americas. There are about 360 species of hummingbirds. These are small birds measuring 7.5 to 13 cm in length. Their weight is up to 4.5 grams. They can live up to 5 years of age. These hummingbirds are the only birds that can fly backward. Hummingbirds are the smallest migrating birds.
Macaws are a group of New World parrots that are long-tailed and often colorful. They are native to North and Central America. Most species are associated with forests, especially rainforest, but others prefer woodland or savanna-like habitats. Macaws are strong and intelligent, though they mostly stick to fruits and few insects for food. The largest parrot by length in the world is 3.3 feet long from the tip of its tail to the top of its head and weighs 1.2 to 1.7 kg in weight.
Birds have been a friend to human civilization for centuries and have helped us in many aspects of our lives. Just like how human beings pass their knowledge from one generation to another, birds exhibit the same tendency of passing their knowledge from one generation to another. Birds tend to live together and have a community and exhibit their social behavior just like human beings. More than admiring the beauty of a bird by locking them in a cage, we can admire their beauty by letting them fly in the sky with freedom. So let's protect birds and make our small part in helping the beautiful species from getting extinct. Thank you.